I'd like to call to order the regular meeting of the Carrabelle Community Redevelopment Agency. It's Tuesday, November 21st, 2017 at 1:30 p.m. We're at Carrabelle City Hall. I ask Commissioner Cal Allen to please say the invocation, and then that will be followed by the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag.
Our God and Father in heaven, we're so grateful that we can come together, and we would like to remind the church of the thankfulness that we have for this little city we live in, for the people who contribute to their efforts to make it better, and also, Father, for our country, this great country that we live in that has survived and survived, and we realize it's under stress and under difficulties, but we pray for your guidance and leadership that we might have the wisdom to deal with it. And for those that are unable to be with us this morning, this afternoon, we ask you to be blessing with them, and we ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, and indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we have roll call. And we have a full CRA board today. We have Mr. Rob Palace, Mr. Bo May, Commissioner Tony Milliger, Commissioner Keith Walden, myself, Brenda Lopez, Commissioner Frank Mathis, and Commissioner Cal Allen. I would call for approval of the minutes, but I didn't receive minutes. Did anyone else receive minutes? October 17, 2017 minutes. Okay.
They were in the packet.
It was scanned with the agenda and sent out with the agenda in a minute.
All right, as one whole link of that, I didn't get to review the minutes.
I looked at the agenda, but I'm sorry, I didn't look any further. So
okay.
I didn't see it, but I could have overlooked it.
Did you see the minutes? Did anyone see the minutes?
I didn't.
Okay, I'll resend them. Okay, well, can we table that for review and approval at our next meeting?
I'll make a motion. We table it and review it for the next meeting.
Okay, all right. We'll do
second.
That. Okay. All right, we'll move on to, do we have any discussion? We have a motion by Commissioner Allen, second by Commissioner Mathis to table for approval of our October 17th minutes at our next meeting. Any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, and that motion carries. We'll move to staff report. The CRA Director, you have a report for us today.
I just wanted to report that our Avenue C parking lot is complete and our Marine Street parking lot is complete. We're finished with both of them jobs.
Okay, very good. And Ms. Susan said she was out there today when it rained and you can hear the water seeping through, she says. All right, City Attorney, staff report, do you have anything, sir?
I do not.
Okay. And you haven't heard anything on the Sonola property, you're now absolutely sure?
No, I have not.
Okay. Is there any public comment? Okay. There's no new business and no old business, so we will move on to the INOVIA Consulting Group projects. Item one, the CRA Director to report on progress of Northwest Avenue B project.
I attended the CDBG workshop last week on our Northwest Avenue B project. We should be ready to go out to bid around the 1st of December. So everything looks good with that project.
I would ask, if it goes to bid the 1st of December, when do you think it would be awarded?
They want your bid to be in for a month. 30 days. So once we advertise it for bid, it'd be 30 days before we award it.
Mm-hmm. So maybe we would possibly be doing that at the January
meeting.
Okay.
If everything stays on schedule.
Otherwise, it would be the February.
Right. If we can get the advertisement in, if Russell's got the bid specs and everything ready, and we can get the advertisement in before, around the middle of December, then we'd be ready for January.
Okay. All right. Do you all have any questions for Ms. Courtney regarding this information or her classes that she took there for this particular project?
None other than the 8th Street parking area and the Escurdy Road Show parking area. And we talked about it a little bit yesterday.
That's the one in front of Fisherman's Wharf that they're just flat out saying that we're not going to be able to put it there because of the gas tanks.
And that's...
With
CRA money.
With that grant.
With grant money. But you can use CRA money, and you can use other funding sources. If it has to be WAF money, or if you possibly could get other grant monies, but not with this CDBG grant will not allow you to put it there.
Yeah, but do we know how much it would cost us to do that on our own?
We'd have to get a price from a contractor.
It wouldn't be bad. I think, and that's what I was going to recommend, is let that project go on and get done, and then come back behind with the CRA money and do it. If you left the, excuse me, with all due respect, Ms. Engineer, if you leave the engineer out, it wouldn't be much to asphalt that and to put a sidewalk. One of our local concrete people could put a sidewalk in there and put that little right-of-way parking.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, that was an unmet need, and it wasn't going to be funded unless we had leftover money anyway. Mm-hmm. So it wasn't part of the project that was guaranteed to be done. It was if we had leftover money.
And I had mentioned before the little part that's right-of-way that's asphalt just below the First Baptist Church, east of the express lane, and it was $10,000. And then the right-of-way that was asphalted there on Avenue C next to the Georgian Motel was $12,000, and that was with engineering involved. And so that would kind of give you an idea if you just hired it done from an asphalt company, just to come in and do that. And then your sidewalk, you could probably go 20 for the sidewalk and somewhere in there asphalting.
I don't think we'd have CRA money to do it this year. I think we pretty much expended that, haven't we?
This project probably won't complete till the next year at this time anyway. So next year at this time, we'll be looking at more CRA income revenue.
Okay.
Or there may be something left over from somewhere. So is there any further discussion? All right, then we'll move on to environmental consulting technology projects. Item one, review progress of the Riverwalk Park Facilities Rehabilitation Project. And Ms. is here to talk to us. She has Mr. Nathan Kiefer.
Yes.
Okay, we're asking.
Yes, he asked him with the little bit of that river we selected to go ahead and do the work. So I haven't asked him to come today to see if anybody had any questions. We have submitted the cost estimate to DEP. They came back and we had to alter some of the wording on the budget sheet to match exactly how it was written in the grant. So instead of being a rehab, it was a renovate. So once we resubmitted that on Monday, we should hear back from them hopefully within the next week or so to get that up. She didn't have any problems with cost. It's just for their accounting department, that way they can match up which bucket stuff something goes into. So we do have it still broke out into renovating the fishing pier and pavilion, renovating the fishing deck, which is the Coast Guard dock, is how they've worded it in the grant, and then re-roofing the pavilion. And then we have renovating the public restroom, which is the new fixtures and the window. And then we also have the new picnic tables, which the city's gonna be purchasing, is how they broke it out. So we've lumped everything into those categories. And I wasn't sure if we wanted to just ask, once they approve the cost, we'll go ahead and draft up the contract with Gaston. I know there was a question of possibly when they would start, but it probably won't be till after the first of the year.
Yeah, probably so.
Yeah. By the time the contract gets signed, that gives DEP, since she's on vacation this week.
Okay, so we can leave our Christmas decorations up then for the, okay. And I know at our last meeting, one of our board members asked if we gave all, instead of piecemealing it out, each project to different builders, if the Gaskin Construction would reduce their price, but I think we've got a no on that. So, okay, just to follow up with the board members that were questioning that, and then we have a 20% contingency currently. So when we were out there talking with Suncoast on the electric part, we did discuss salvaging the deck boards off the pavilion.
Right. If they're in good shape, would it be possible to, that the city could salvage some of those boards, if possible?
Yeah. I mean, what I would be willing to do is stack them, and you pick them up, but we couldn't take the fasteners out and all that good stuff. The plan was just take them, throw them directly into a dumpster, and get rid of them.
Yeah.
And it is very time consuming to clean the boards up.
I understand.
Is that okay?
Well, we're just going to discuss it now. And the thing was that the boards are in bad condition, and originally we had all discussed pressure washing that part of it. They're not in bad, but somehow now they're worked out with a grant or something that they're being replaced. But Susan and Courtney and I discussed that he lifts up the boards on the Coast Guard dock because there's three layers of decking there, and he lifts up the first layer and sees something that underneath that needs repair. Possibly he could use salvage boards from the pavilion decking. That's what we really had in mind, and so I'm just sharing that information with y'all now. So just to ask these gentlemen what they might think about that.
Sounds good, man.
But would you be able to do that?
I would never use recycled wood, but just to be honest with everybody, okay. I would never use it myself. Mm-hmm. If we're going to replace something and spend time and money to tear it out and replace it, the cost of lumber would not be a huge cost. Mm-hmm. The labor is what would be the big cost. I would never reuse it. Just to be completely honest with everybody.
Okay. All right.
Why does it have three layers?
Probably over the years, maybe they just added another layer and it's been there for quite some time, that Coast Guard box.
Is that the way the city received it?
They received it way before me.
Okay.
Well, my question is, from a layman's perspective, I'm not a building contractor, but I'm not naive to wood and how it works, and decks, etc. Built my own. Those bottom layers are going to hold moisture. And I see him nodding his head. Those would be the first to go, that first layer and that second layer, because they're not going to be exposed to the wind and the sun to dry. And they're going to hold moisture, and they would rot much faster than that up top. And I agree with him. You know, if you pull the top layer up and you have bad wood on the second layer, I wouldn't want to put used wood there. I'd want to put good wood there, because that's the layer that's probably going to go the quickest. If I was going to have to use used wood, I would put that on top. Or it would be more exposed to the sun and the wind, or it could dry. Mm-hmm. Anyway, just me.
No, and it's open for discussion, because we didn't know that it had three layers until the contractors went out and looked at it.
What if we pull the top layer up, bottom, and the second layer is bad, just replace the second layer, forget the third layer?
I don't know. I honestly can't say I don't know.
I think you'll know more once we get in there to see what it...
If it's strong enough to have one layer, that's all you need. If it's strong enough to have that.
What's the bottom layer?
That's what I'm asking. What's the bottom layer?
Well, the more ones we pull up, start running.
No, I agree with you.
And then on the Suncoast, are they're going to make us a task order that's going to, this is electric now, that will have each little project, each area that they're going to.
What we'll do is we'll have them reword their proposal and break it out into the categories that are in the grant, to word that way. Mm-hmm. So that way, because that was in the grant application, we were doing electrical on that dock. Mm-hmm.
And the whole thing now, the whole facility.
Right, yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're doing the landing area. So what we'll do is, since they already gave us the one proposal, we'll just have them kind of rewrite their proposal into the four categories of the grant. Mm-hmm.
We had one electrical conduits, 4,000, mm-hmm. now, and our at our last meeting, added additional funding to upgrade that.
Right. Okay. And remove some of the structures that are on the Coast Guard dock. We're going to come in and do that since there's the old pedestal from the electrical when the Coast Guard ships used to fly out there. Kind of a trip hazard out there, so kind of remove stuff that's not being used for anything out there. Yes, sir.
I'd like to make a stab in the dark here.
Okay.
Not knowing what we have. And you guys chime in for sure and leave. And you too. If he pulls that top layer up, mm-hmm. and the bottom layer has problems, I would suggest replacing that bottom layer, mm-hmm. and do not go back with that third layer if it's structurally sound and is good. Mm-hmm. There's no need for that third layer if that's the case. Mm-hmm. And I would make a motion that we do that. Mm-hmm.
So we have to look at transitions.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. The transitions between different areas. If you take an inch of lumber off, it may not be handicap accessible necessarily anymore. So that would be one thing that really would come from.
Yeah, have to look at that.
But we're only supposed to remove one layer. Yeah. So if we pull it up and there's something below,
Yeah, the way it was written is that they're going to first inspect that bottom layer, and if it isn't, they'll just put the new layer on top.
You gonna put the new layer on top of bad wood?
Anything will be replaced, but the plan is that'll be, we've added contingency for any wood that needs to be replaced underneath. So there is a contingency in there for that.
How would that top layer make it handicap accessible and the two layers would not?
Well, the way it is now, everything is the way the ramps are and everything's a smooth transition. So if you took a layer out, you could have a gap.
Yeah, but that could be easily transitioned. What size decking do you use? 5/4 decking?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's easily transitioned for handicap accessible.
Well, you want to look at the ramp that goes down to the floating dock too. There's a couple. Mm-hmm. We'll definitely look at that. We don't want to have to put additional back that we don't need to. But
ADA compliance is a really big deal too. Mm-hmm. That there's.
Well, I'm not trying to do away with ADA compliance. I understand what you're saying. I just don't want to put another deck on top of a deck. It's not necessary. And I, like I said, I'm taking a stab in the dark. I'm sitting here. I haven't looked at it. I have no idea. And again, it may not be strong enough with the materials built out of. It may not be strong enough with two layers. I don't know. And if it's 5/4 decking and not 2x, then naturally it's not as strong as what 2x would be. 2-inch thick versus 5/4 inches thick. But again, I just feel like that's just asking for. I wouldn't do it myself. Make two or three layers out of something that wasn't necessary, that's going to hold moisture and cause it to rot quicker, and which it definitely would.
Now you mentioned making a motion. Would you like?
Well, I kind of was going forward with that, and he just did on removing one layer. And what I was saying is making a motion, if they take the top layer off and the second layer is bad, just replace the second layer and don't put the third layer back on.
But
but he made the statement there that he only bid to take one layer off. And she said that there's contingency there to replace one or two bad boards, but not an entire deck. I don't know how large this deck is. How large is the deck?
Are we going to do our pre-discussion meeting now there after this meeting, since you want to come down?
If it's bad, then you're going to put a new one on top of the third layer.
I think I would just say what we make, and we are going to meet down there, convene at the pavilion and Coast Guard dock after this meeting, if you all want to. We've scheduled that. That's what they're here for, if you'd like to do that. But then, as Commissioner Mathis says, the third layer, you know, what happens, and it's...
It's been there probably longer than the second one has.
It probably has.
And I agree with what Frank was saying. I was just going to the second layer because that's all we have really addressed, is the top layer and the middle layer, if you want to say it that way.
But I guess we need to get in there and see when the boards come up and see what happens.
That would be inspected when the top comes up.
I'm certainly not going to put a whole lot of expensive material on top of anything, right?
Right.
I'm certainly not going to do that.
And so we'll probably certainly be looking at possibly a change order of some sort.
Like I said, we did build in that, added that 20% to each line, to each item. So there's 20% to each item, each category.
That's what I was thinking. If we get in there and there's more than we really believe, we could do a change order and up it a little bit to deal with.
What do you mean by 20% for each category?
The way that you have the renovating the fishing pier, you have renovating the
the three different
each
areas.
Each one got a 20%, correct, for the grant, too, because of submitting the estimate to DEP. We tried to put everything we could think of in there. Now you might not, when the roof might be pretty straightforward, you know, looks like there might be one spot, there might be, but, you know, a lead in, but, you know, we might not need some of that, so we're still looking on, you know, other categories. But we wanted to just make sure, in case there was any unforeseen, once they started tearing off, any of the decking, any of the roofing, that there was any surety, you know, we'll repair everything while we're there.
And what was the total amount that you sent to the DEP?
It was $175,143.
Okay.
And that also included labor hours for city workers.
Okay, I have something similar to that right in mind right now.
It wasn't going to cover the admin, unfortunately, but it does cover the labor.
And that included your engineering
price
as well. Now, if we go out to the deck, can we, since it's still part of the meeting, can we make motions there?
I mean, I know we just talked about it being. There's going to be a pre-construction meeting at the site.
Mm-hmm.
That's typically meeting staff. Commissioners can attend, but we have never advertised it or we haven't opened that to the public.
Okay.
Right now, so.
We don't have a contract yet, technically. We kind of wanted to let, you know, if somebody did have questions, we could. So if anything we needed to put in the contract, we can put in the contract.
I'm going to say again because you mentioned a motion. So.
No, well, it's difficult to make a motion in the direction that I was thinking because of the way it's bid out and where we're financed for. And it's difficult to make the motion not knowing whether the deck would be structurally sound with one layer of wood. And I know it depends on what size of wood, and that contractor knows better than I do. If the type of wood and size of wood, one deck may be better than three, or three sounds like they're just trying to gather a thickness, which the thicker it is, the more weight it carries.
Well, they probably, when the Coast Guard ship was there, they probably hauled heavy items across there, also, possibly. That was a pretty big
And if that bottom deck's been there since the Coast Guard cutter was there? Anyway, difficult to make a motion on not knowing what we have. And I'm with this man here, I mean, you know, and I know he's a contractor, and he made a statement, and I respect it, that he's not gonna put good wood on top of bad wood, but if he gets into a significant amount of bad wood, then it may exceed our 20%. And that's kind of where I was going with it. Not only with cost, but practicality, whether we actually need three layers or not. Do you know what the weight carrying capacity, of course, that's going to depend too on how much bracing you have, weight carrying capacity of that 5/4 deck, and that's going to depend on how much bracing and how far the spacing, et cetera.
Yes, it will.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, that's my thoughts.
Okay. Well, I would just what can we do? But just let it come up, let the decking come up, and see what we're faced with.
So that's our engineer.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so until they pull that top, maybe we don't. Nobody has any idea what's in there. Although there's a couple boards I think are missing, you know, on the end. But, you know.
I haven't been on it. Can you see them?
No, they're alternating.
Yeah. Right. Okay, they're gotcha.
So then we'll go back to the salvaging of the deck boards on the pavilion. Do we want to do that?
We might have to do that. That one just
If they're decent, I wouldn't throw them out. I mean, you could just put them in a pile,
good,
like you said.
They're good boards.
You mentioned something about money being in there for labor, city labor. City labor is what it's going to take to
clean
them, to denail them or proper screws.
That's actually nailed.
Is it really?
That's yes.
And that kind of thing. And if the boards are good, salvage them. And I would hate to say I'm with him with the contractor. I'd hate to put it back on there, but I'd rather see good used wood put on top than on bottom if we had to do that. And does that make sense, what I'm trying to say? And he's not going to, you know, he didn't bid in there to clean that wood up to use it. I understand that. So.
There was a small amount of it I'm coming out.
Sure.
This is a lot.
If it turns into a significant amount, that's
right. We just wouldn't be able to put it on top, though, because we're putting composite up.
Right, okay.
Yeah. Gotcha.
More than likely, it's going to be damaged taking it up anyway, just so you all know.
Well,
it's not going to just jump up off there. It's going to take some force. And it's probably a good portion of it's going to be damaged.
And as far as the nails, I'd say take a chop saw and cut the part off. It's got the nails in it.
Well, they're 16 inches.
Then I've got small pieces.
Right.
I've
worked
with. Super nail.
Yes, sir. You take two before you to make a nice floor out of
it. Super glue.
Any other discussion okay any motions to be made? All right, then, and then we'll look forward to you starting after the first of the year. And you're going to do the roof first, right?
Depends on how things work out.
Okay.
Whoever shows up first is the one that's going to go first.
But now we don't want roofing going on damaging our
well that would be my concern.
Yeah.
If anything's damaged, I'm on it. So until you guys sign off, so if it happens, it's my dollar, not yours. But the way things are in our construction, everybody's terribly busy. So whoever can come first is the one that's going to go first. Mm-hmm. I would prefer to do the roof first, but if you're busy, mm-hmm. we just can move there. That's the way it'll work out.
So I guess a couple things you could possibly do at the same time, like either the restroom
or
two
ways.
Yeah,
the other dock.
Yes. Okay. So.
That would be ideal.
Right.
Yeah.
Just real quick, a question back on the board salvage issue. your responsibility is just to take them or remove them from the, excuse me?
Just to dispose of them.
Okay, you remove them from the site, that's your responsibility?
Yes, we'll get a dumpster out, put them in the dumpster.
So if...
Excuse me?
If we chose to let you just leave them there on site, then our responsibility?
The liability would still be mine if someone tripped over them or got nailed in them.
Until we release them, yeah.
If I throw them in a dumpster and somebody climbs in the dumpster, the liability's not as great if I leave them stacked up by the public parking area with nails exposed.
Okay, move forward.
All right, this came to my mind. Are we bound by that grant to replace that decking under the pavilion?
It was in there to do that. We're not bound to do it. You're just going to have two different deckings. Because, you'll have composite everywhere else but there.
And composite on the fishing pier that's out in the sun. And I'm just thinking it might be a better idea if we're not bound to replace that decking under the pavilion, which that was not in the original discussion when we started discussing this 2 years ago. It was just to pressure wash that pavilion decking and redo the Coast Guard dock and redo the fishing pier. Would it be better to redo the Coast Guard dock first, renovate that, rehab it, whatever you had to call it for the grant, and see what we run into, and then if there's money left, do the decking on the pavilion?
Well, we could do that. We have 3 years to spend the money also, so I mean, it's not something we have to do all this year. But I mean, it just might it's going to change your bid. You're changing the scope a little bit, so.
Why?
Well, just because we're going to be taking out that large, rejecting that large area, so. The little fishing deck and that pavilion was
one unit?
Yeah, that would be.
Right. Yeah, it was one unit, and then the Coast Guard dock was another unit. But we still could possibly start there.
On the Coast Guard dock.
Right.
See what you run into.
I apologize.
No, it's fine.
Okay, we're just trying to, I hate to tear up a good deck when we've got a potentially rotten deck next door. And I would ask that the commissioners and the board members go out there and take a look at the pavilion decking and the other decking to assist.
But we're not going to know what that bottom deck is till it's torn up. Just as he said, you can't see it. But just common sense, in my opinion, just common sense, says this held moisture all these years, it's not going to be in the best of shape. That's just my opinion. And he may take it up, it may be cypress wood, and it may be the best in the world. But there again, my opinion is that it's not going to be the best in the world, that bottom layer.
We could write the contract to start with that. I guess it just depends.
I would rather not be contractually bound to start in any one area.
Right, sure.
If we're going to do them both, I'd like the option to do them together.
Because you have all the decking for everything.
Would we have to rebid that?
Can't we just start with the Coast Guard dock and see what happens and worry about that before we have to rebid?
But then you'd be ordering the decking twice, kind of, because you would order all the decking at once.
Yes.
Order all the decking
for everything.
You get a decent discount if you buy an
large
amount of it. And it's actually a pretty significant discount. And so ordering, just that little bit, I think it was like 1,400 square feet on one, 3,500 on the other. If you order 1,300 square feet at one time, you're paying maybe 50 cents a square foot more for it.
So there's four pieces here. Let me just be clear here. There's four pieces. There's a pavilion and fishing pier rehab. There's a pavilion roof. There's a former Coast Guard dock rehab and a public restroom rehab. So I think what we're talking about doing, and you had said last month that we could spread this over 3 years.
Correct.
The way it's been.
Yeah, because we have a grant, because we have a grant for 3 years.
So could we start with the Coast Guard dock rehab first, find out what's underneath there, and that's not going to, that won't affect the other three pieces. It is another three pieces, correct?
I don't know how they bid it. I mean, I don't, yeah.
I know.
They're bid separate.
But yeah, they are bid separate, yeah, yeah.
I'll tell you this right now, we were way low. If you rebid it, I'll be way low again. I mean, I'm just telling you honestly, we're 30,000 bucks low. And so if you remove this $58,000, it's not gonna be $58,000 next time, basically. If you go back and look at the bid tabs, you'll see, we were a good bid low.
I'm not suggesting we remove that. I'm suggesting we start with the Coast Guard piece first, find out what we're dealing with underneath there, and then we make a decision on, I mean, it probably will not be a decision to be made. We should probably just go ahead with the rest of the project. But if we don't have any money, it's not gonna matter anyway. I mean, if we find out that the Coast Guard's gonna cost us 40% or 60% more, we're not gonna have the money for the pavilion rehab anyway. So I guess why not just start with the Coast Guard dock first, find out what we're dealing with, and then chances are everything's gonna go great and smooth. I'm optimistic, but at least we know.
So it wouldn't be contracted to do the entire job at once?
Well, we're not getting any kind of benefit out of doing it all at once.
That's up for you guys to decide.
We just talked about cost.
Cost-wise, you having the savings by doing it all at once.
I thought that was the first thing we talked about here, that we weren't getting the savings.
Well, no. I'm just talking, if he had what we ordered, all of the wood.
He's going to order every all the wood for all of the all four projects, whatever wood is involved, and the polymer decking, he's going to order all of that at once, even though only one project's going to be done. I guess you'll keep that stored off-site or somewhere.
You'd roll right from one to the other.
It would get a significant reduction for ordering that much.
We don't get any benefit out of that.
He's the lowest bid.
Yeah. I can see where he's coming from, but when we sent it out to bid, did we bid it out with the contractors knowing it was a 3-year period for this to be done and done?
It was clear that it'd be done at separate
events. Separate events. And so when they bid on it, they realized it would be done in separate events. But I'm not trying to say anything. I don't understand where you're coming from. And that makes perfectly good sense. Mm-hmm.
And that's where I was last month, we did not have to award these contracts, all four to one contractor. And I had asked the question, if we award all four to one contractor, would we have any savings on that? And you have answered that as no. So it seemed to me that we could at least start with Project C first, and we wouldn't have any additional
cost. Yeah, this gentleman, what he's trying to tell us, he's going to order what it takes to do the complete job, and if he breaks it up, then costs are going to have to go up because he's not going to get it at the same price.
I understand what he's saying, but yet still what Susan's saying is when it was bid out, the contractors realized that it could be done separately.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, yeah. I do everything individually.
And it wouldn't be out, it could be done over a 3-year period. One done here, one done 6 months, one done in 7 months, etc.
But we could be held our price, of course. I mean, once we sign a contract, whatever you guys decide to do is all the way.
If we have a contract signed, we'd still be.
That's it. So if you decide to leave the larger portion out, contract the other three portions, then the large portion to be able to rebid.
Okay, but I do agree with what Ron's saying, and that's kind of going right back in line with what I was saying earlier, is just trying to look at it from a priority perspective. That one seems to be the highest priority, that Coast Guard dock, and being so because it's totally exposed to the weather.
And your fishing here, that was very...
Exactly. I haven't looked at them, but that's true. I'm new to this, but I'm just trying to think on the coast.
Your railing is very unstable and your fishing here. The railing is very unstable.
And that's cool, but the priorities come first.
Right.
And then I agree, if that decking underneath that pavilion, is that 5'4" deck?
It's up.
That decking under that pavilion's been under a roof. Obviously, it's decent, okay? And if it is, and we have to sacrifice anything, that would be the one that we would want to say, okay, it's in still in good condition. However, if it's not, then yes, we have the opportunity to replace it and replace it. But I see where he's going to listen, and I agree with that. Kind of start at one, start at the highest priority and work that way. And hopefully, we're not going to run into an issue with those bottom layers.
And our Coast Guard dock is a high priority. It's dangerous. There's boards missing and boards have been pulled off and railings are, you know, in a disarray. It is a dangerous location. Now the fishing pier off the pavilion is also dangerous. I don't know which one is more dangerous at this point. Yeah, I guess.
I was just going to try to ask the question back again. Hypothetically, of course, you're not going to be able to answer this, I know definitely, until you get into it. Let's just say you had to go down to the first layer, and we had to have you do that and shift money elsewhere. And I'm going to kind of direct this to Susan, too. Hypothetically, if we had to do that, 20% from each one of these projects, would that be enough money out of that, Susan, to cover for him going all the way down to the bottom layer?
Well, if you're tearing your out, we wouldn't go back with all three layers. I agree.
Don't go back with three layers.
I don't know what his labor...
I'm paying $2 a square foot just to have it removed.
Right.
And that's with no markup for me. That's what we're going to pay. Yeah. It's $2 a square foot just to have it taken out.
Right.
But now if you start taking it up, three layers, I might get a little break on it, but I'm going to pay $2 a square foot.
Okay, and that's cool. My question is will we have enough if we had to do that out of the 20% from each one of those projects to cover him going right on down to the...
Because that was about 1,400. Oh, that seemed a little, might be a little higher than 1,400, but then we need to times that by $2 a square foot.
And that's what I'm saying.
So yes, I mean, like I said, we added 20 every single one of his lines.
And if we did it that way, then we could probably squeeze enough pennies and nickels from the rest of these to go ahead and do the whole thing and get it done. If matters are really bad.
Right.
If matters are really bad, we won't have to wrestle with it that much.
Yeah. Now, and he's got $28,452 for the Coast Guard dock.
Right.
And then the contingency is $23,647.
Okay, so you see, we're not far from it right there.
Yes. And that's the only other place that I could see where we would run into deep problems, but it's not that big, would be the fishing pier. So it's that fishing pier is not, you know, not nearly like the as much.
I wouldn't expect too much under the pavilion and being a fishing pier.
Yeah.
And it was the whole area had the 20%, which I think was so would be 20% of the 58.
I assume you guys have city employees that...
Yes, we did.
Fairly many. Why not let them take up a small piece and look under it before you contract with anybody?
I was going to say, what's the turnaround time on ordering the materials? Could you just do an exploratory or go there and pull that first layer off, get a look at it, then place the order for all of it or however?
Yeah, I mean, it's easy to get.
You know, I mean, get that torn up and take a look at it.
But before you contract with us, you all look at it, maybe pay her to come check it out and see, get her opinion on what's under. Then that would let you know which direction to go with us.
Well,
I think just a couple of places would give you a really good idea.
Get her to look at it?
Yeah, get an engineer or somebody that you trust somebody's opinion, trust.
She gonna charge it.
No, you just gotta pay something. As long as you trust them, that's all that matters, that you trust whoever looks at it. Engineer, whoever, but somebody you trust, but if they just pull up to their small places.
Right.
Then.
Isn't there a few boards missing already?
There is on the ends, yeah.
Susan, if we pulled all three layers, would it change the type of material that we would go back on there with?
We still want to go back with the composite.
Yeah, but would it change the?
The spacing of the joists would be.
Right.
Right.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, the space, the, how, where your joists are placed.
The pavilion is done correctly to have, I know that because you can see the.
16 inch?
Yes.
Yeah.
But the other is turned, you know, opposite direction is that, well, it's just made for the point two.
Right.
So it's hard to tell, the spacing of the joists under.
Well, knowing the government, if they thought it would take to, for 10,000 pound, they built it for 30,000.
Probably.
Without a doubt.
No, I was doing, I want back to Rob here, but I support what he's saying, and kind of started that one end down there. Now, he does have a good point, and here again, he knows this better than the rest of us. If Streets and Roads took a crew of the inmates down there and pulled up part of that, and if we knew the timing of when this gentleman was gonna start his process, we just go ahead and close the dock to public use. And pull up a little piece of it with inmates and see what we got down there, and then we could report back to him, and she could take a look at it.
Would you wanna come down and see?
I'm gonna take direction from you all.
Yeah.
Now, you've got, part of this is in kind, right?
She had said.
Some of this is in kind, city, but.
Correctly, some of their hours are.
I'm just wondering about having city crews with inmate crews taking up a fair amount of it. Can they do that?
I would think so.
Yeah, no problem, you just have to get the ward approved.
If we were gonna do the work, I would rather not take up a lot.
Because his price did include that.
I mean, if they wanna take off a couple of exploratory areas, that's fine, I'll patch them back at no cost, but if we're talking about them taking up any large amount, that's a story.
Okay.
But if you want to cut a couple of places out, and just get an idea, in two or three places along the dock.
What would happen if they cut out a spot that was good, and next to do it is rotted?
Well, that's, but chances are, that happens rarely in an instance like that, but it could, but it's rare to be that way.
Well, I think we should explore it, take out two or three areas. Excuse me?
I was just asking him about if he was gonna go with that one project, which is what he was suggesting.
I think for sure we need to have the Streets and Roads crew go out there and take up about three spots, for sure, with school, to take a look at it. If there's some way that we can start with that first, you know, it seems like it's the consensus here, if you could start with the Coast Guard deck, so we could just, you know, get some kind of an idea on what we're facing there.
All right.
Yeah, it's like that.
So, it's gonna be around the 1st of January then, before you start, say, mid-January, you know, I'm just trying to get an idea when these fellows can come.
Contract and all that stuff.
Yeah, stuff in mercy of DP, and I hope we have that within next week or so.
Okay.
Holidays, everything flows down, they go.
So,
And it's like one, there's, I think, two people for the whole state for all the grants.
Courtney, then, after New Year's, you know, a week or so after, have them go out there and do, say, three places. And then we'll go ahead and rope it off at Commissioner Bellinger's suggestion.
That should be done before we're contracting, if it were not up with, in my opinion.
And that can be done anytime, really.
Yeah, like tomorrow.
Because you're gonna tackle back down.
Oh, tomorrow.
And go ahead and get an idea of what's there. Susan can go and check it out, whoever you all choose to inspect it, and And then you can go from there with the contracting with us.
Isn't there somebody in this area that's certified to check out that type of structure?
We might be able to get someone to do it just as a favor, one of our local contractors.
It would be even if you have to pay, because I'm not going to look at it and say it's good or bad.
And yes, Ms. Keisha?
Are you wanting us to put the pieces back?
If they took a small enough area out, and they could take it back temporarily, but I don't mind fixing it back, as long as it's a small area now.
Right. But you don't want us to rip it off and just leave it uncovered?
Yeah, that'd be good. That'd be...
You want us to put it back?
Well, I mean, y'all own it until we start, so that, you know, that would be up to y'all.
It's all your liability for what you want to do.
Yeah.
And so, as soon as the DEP gives approval on the budget, then we will be requested to sign a contract with Gaskin, which you're expecting to be within the next 2 to 3 weeks.
Right.
Can I go after Thanksgiving, the week after Thanksgiving?
It would have to be Monday.
Yeah, before that, our
It's the center of that. If everything looks great under it, it doesn't matter. But if it were to be rotten, then of course that would impact everything, and it would impact what you all want to contract with us.
We have about, there's about $28,000 worth of contingency notes, so kind of quick math.
Well, and the mayor just pointed out that that's what the bid was for that particular part of this project.
28,452. I think we need to take a look at it. We won't have another meeting until mid-December, so unless we want to call like an emergency meeting for the CRA board, that's what we would have to do.
I thought we would agree to in the DC.
Well, I haven't gotten to that part yet. So I'm just going to request that we do cancel the December meeting, which is December the something, 19th. But he's going to want to know, you know, the contract's most likely going to need to be signed before December the 19th. How can we communicate with the board members?
Courtney can take direction and deal directly with Susan and the contractor.
Okay, without having to have a meeting.
Yeah.
All right. So we'll have the Streets and Roads crew go out there Monday. Courtney will and take a look at it. And that doesn't mean that y'all can't go out there and take a look at it. See what's going on, take some pictures, we'll just move from there. Although I would prefer that we start on the Coast Guard dock, since like Mr. Powers would, since like Commissioner Millenburg would. Would you like them to start on the Coast Guard dock?
That's fine, man.
Would be a good thing if you could.
But to me, like, if you take a good auger and go down in different places and see what come up in the second, third layer.
Get a core sample.
Get a core of it. Get underneath and look up.
We would also need to coordinate then the electrical, because they're supposed to come in also. So it's already moved that.
I imagine you'll find that first layer will be chrysoed. Back when that was put down.
Yeah.
And it may still be good for Christmas.
I just imagine that's what it'll be when it was constructed.
So you want your electrical to come in? When does that come in?
Well, if you want them to start with it, because he'll probably need to, they'll come in right there when they're starting that, because they're going to remove some of that, those fixtures out there and that pedestal. That would be out of their way, so they don't see it coming first before the meeting starts.
Okay.
This decking that you're putting down, what's it called, column?
Yes, composite.
That composite, better, yeah.
Like Trex.
That's the Trex, the brand name.
Yeah. Composite deck I've seen, don't have any personal experience with it, but I've saw it. And you were mentioning 5/4. Do they make thicker?
Yes, they do.
2 inch?
Well, it's normal, it's 1.5 thick.
So you got, your choices on thickness is 5/4, 1.5 inches?
Yes.
That's only 1/4 inch.
Well, 5/4 is not 5/4. It's not thick as well, it's 1 inch. Sometimes 7/8, 1 inch.
Five quarter inch and a half, still nominal, so there's still not much difference.
There's big difference in money.
Yeah.
A big difference, over twice.
Probably the strength, though, has got a lot of difference too. And composite. Don't take much of that for so strong.
So you would be more cost effective to put 2 layers of 5/4 than you would 1 layer of 1.5 inches?
Yeah, 16-foot 5/4 board's about $40, and 1.5 inches is about $96. So, actually, it's cheap, 2-for-1 deal.
So you would put 2 layers of...
Single layer.
Okay.
I'm thinking ahead of the game, Mayor, I'm thinking about the...
Yeah, but you bid it based on that, those specs, and if we go to change it, we're gonna have to rebid it.
Well, yes, sir. All we can do is just go out there and take a look and see what we have, and we'll work with you if you can work with us. I mean, this, the Coast Guard dock is in poor condition, and I know you saw it, and it needs to be repaired. So, is there any other discussion? Bo, you've been mighty quiet, sir.
Five-fourths, four-fifths, five-fourths, 1.5. I mean, what reality factor is out there? Take a look.
It is what it is.
Go out there and drill it, thing, Frank. We'll figure it out
for you. Drive a nail in. If it falls through, it ain't no good.
Okay. All right, then. We'll move forward. No, you weren't expecting this, but...
This one?
Okay.
Right.
we got to watch our pennies here, and we're concerned about what's underneath. Okay. All right, so we'll just call that one to a close for now, and we have the next item is our CRA board projects, which we have none at this point. So then we'll have our next item is other items brought forward by the CRA board members. And does anyone have an item they'd like to bring forward at this point? Yes, sir.
I'd like to propose that starting in January that we meet on a quarterly basis, given that we have limited money and limited projects. So it would be every quarter, January, April, whatever.
Are you wanting to make a motion on that?
I'll make a motion, yes.
Okay, so we have a motion by Mr. Powis to meet quarterly.
Beginning in January.
Do we have a second on that?
I'll second.
Okay. Okay, so that motion is by Mr. Powis and a second by Commissioner Millender to meet quarterly starting in January of 2018. Discussion, and I do have some discussion. And I would like to say that that's not out of the question, but I'm concerned about the big Avenue B project that's coming up, and there may need to be some decisions that have to be made about that project. And I would suggest meeting. We need to take a look too. There's a Florida statute that governs how CRA boards are operating and what they can do and can't do. And
I'll look at that. I'll look at the next.
Okay. It's either quarterly or as every other month. I can't remember which one it is, but I would suggest at this point, until that CDBG project gets going, that we meet every other month. six times a year, and then after that, we can consider quarterly if it's allowed by Florida statute.
So when will we start February, February?
Well, if we, and I was going to motion to cancel the December 19th meeting, and we would need to meet in January to award the CDBG bids that are going to be advertised shortly. And that's a major project, this CDBG project coming up. And if we see that if they don't need us every other month, then we can, or we could also, if it's allowed by Florida statute, we could meet quarterly, but we could also call a meeting whenever it's necessary. Is that correct, Courtney and Keisha?
Yes.
So we can do that with them. All right, so we have a motion and a second, and my discussion then would be that we meet in January, and between now and then, we'll find out what the Florida statute is. And if it looks that we need to meet regarding the CDBG project, then we'll call for a meeting. Otherwise, I would say we can meet quarterly if the Florida statute, contingent on the Florida statute. So this would be contingent on the Florida statute. So I'm going to call for a vote.
Just a minute.
Okay.
If I'm not mistaken, you're not adding that to his motion.
No.
You can't do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's just
the vote's just on his motion. Mm-hmm. That's correct. Now we can revisit this issue in January.
That we can.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
And I was looking to see if Mr. Hartman might be.
I'm hustling here. I'm trying to see if I can dig it out of the statute.
160.
If I can't get it done right now, it'll be probably this afternoon.
Okay.
I can't find it here. Don't let me hold things up.
All right. So we'll have a motion to meet quarterly beginning January in 2018. For next year, and that motion is by Mr. Powell, second by Commissioner Millender. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, and that motion carries. All right, then, and next we're going to adjourn, and we're going out to the pavilion.
Are we bringing up the December?
Oh, sorry. I would like to ask someone to motion that we cancel the December 19th meeting.
I'll make the motion to cancel the December 19th meeting.
Second.
Okay, so we have a motion by Commissioner Allen, second by Commissioner Mathis to cancel the December 19th, 2017 CRA meeting. Is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, and that motion carries. Okay, are there any other items that the CRA board would like to bring? I just want to remind y'all, Holiday on the Harbor, December the 9th, the CRA is sponsoring the fireworks after the boat parade, and there's going to be other activities around Carrabelle on December the 8th, but here and there, so y'all be in town to enjoy the festivities. Yes, sir.
Before you adjourn, Keisha, tell me. Sorry, but if we're talking about having the whole CRA board go down to the dock for at least more than one mm-hmm. person, and then I would not adjourn the meeting until you're done with that.
Okay.
So basically move the meeting down to the dock, is that what we're doing?
That's what I understood.
That's kind of what I understood from Ms. Courtney. I'm trying to see if it's raining, but now that the door is blocked.
And I would... Yeah, I'm reconvening the meeting now.
Okay.
I need four of you.
Well, we actually haven't voted on the motion.
Sorry, we didn't vote on the which motion?
To adjourn. Did we?
No.
Right, but if we adjourn,
we have
it is all
we need to rescind that motion.
On the jump, I didn't know.
We haven't had a motion yet.
This was not announced.
I just called.
Right, but before you adjourn, I'm just saying, this idea of having a bunch of board members get down to the dock and discuss what we're just discussing in the meeting and all that on a very technical basis or that, we can't do that. So either one member of the board can go down there, no problem with the director and figure this out. But if more than one member is compelled to go down to that dock here in the rain, then we need basically the easiest way to do that and say the sunshine thing is to literally announce right here that, you know, we're not adjourned, we're moving. We're announcing we're going down to that dock to continue the meeting. I mean, is more than one member of the board going down to that dock here in a minute? I mean, they can go down on their own time, but we're having a pre-construction meeting at the dock with the CRA board participating. That wasn't announced, that wasn't noticed.
And I had planned to go, but I would like as many members go as if want to, if they can.
I suggest that they just let individually go one at a time and not be a public meeting, and then.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Then we don't have to bid with anything of advertising it, getting ready.
Yeah, that makes it simple.
For a public meeting, and, you know, it's just really simple, trying to do it just with individuals.
And we can adjourn this meeting before five.
Well, I kind of disagree with Commissioner Cal. And the reason why is, I agree that we can move the meeting. I'm not the expert by any means, but from my knowledge, we can move the meeting with that. If we go individually, that's wonderful, but then individually, we've got to discuss it with court.
Yes.
And we don't have the option of discussing it with each other. Where if we go down there, I'm going, I'd like to go down there if it's not storming. It sounds like the mayor wants to go, and just to look. And I'd like to be able to not sit there with my lips sewed up.
Well, I think, I mean, that thing is.
The communication flows better when you're together than it is getting it individually.
It's not as high as, so, you know, we're able to get our ideas out better.
But it's not, the problem is, it's sunshine, so.
I don't understand that.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Move the meeting.
You want to go?
Don't you violate the sunshine law, I don't agree.
We're not violating if we move the meeting down there.
If we move the meeting down there.
The only other, again, this is all lawyer stuff, so I can honor yours, but to then adjourn the meeting after the meeting, after moving it, how are you gonna have a hard time adjourning that without having a forum? I mean, you can go down there without a forum. Do four people wanna go or not?
I want to go.
Hold your hands up if you wanna go.
Raise your hands.
All right, so no quorum, no quorum. So, so that leaves only three out of us, gotta have four.
Okay.
So that leaves us with two options, which one I don't recommend, but it could be done. But one is that you go down individually, communicate with Courtney. Number two, that you can go down, you just can't talk.
That's fine. We'll go along with that. I was just suggesting that I'd rather do it as a group, but if we can't do that, Dan, that's just the way it is.
Yeah, you can't. Don't do it as a group. Yeah, it's one at a time.
I'm not certified to go and say it's good or bad.
But that's the point of the meetings, is to
okay.
Show back up and talk about it.
Well, I won't go down there right now in the rain. The mayor can go.
All right.
Is it pouring down rain now? All right, so you want us to, we need to adjourn then.
Yes. I'm making a motion to adjourn.
Okay, so we have a motion by Mr. Powell to adjourn. Do we have a second?
Second.
Second by Commissioner Millender. Any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? And then that motion carries. All right, thank you, gentlemen.